Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to give you seven latest defense updates. Number one, US eyes Indian mega defense projects. The US defense industry is ramping up its efforts to secure a foothold in India's massive military modernization plans. Following its offer to co-develop Stryker-based armored vehicles, the Pentagon now sets its sight on the colossal Future Ready Combat Vehicle FRCV program. The FRCV project, valued at ₹57,000 crores, aims to place India's aging fleet of T-72 tanks with 1,770 next generation combat vehicles by 2030-35. These advanced machines will boast cutting-edge features like artificial intelligence, integrated drone capabilities, and active protection systems. Next, prototypes roll out for AMCA. The Indian Air Force dream of a homegrown fifth-generation fighter jet, the advanced medium combat aircraft, is inching closer to reality following approval from the Cabinet Committee on Security earlier this year. The development program has received a significant boost. According to the information obtained, the first prototype of the AMCA is expected to take flight within the next 4.5 years, placing its first flight in late 2028. Next, RFI issued for VVIP choppers. The Indian Air Force is reigniting its quest for a new fleet of helicopters to transport the country's VVIPs, including the President, Vice President, the Prime Minister. This move comes nearly a decade after the controversial Augusta Westland deal collapsed due to corruption allegations. Next, C-17 successor race. Will India join the club? The future of the C-17 Globemaster III, a workhorse military transport aircraft, is a topic of debate. While current operators like India yearn for more, the question remains, should production resume with the existing design or should a modernized version take flight? The C-17 boasts an impressive track record with a high mission capable rate and a loyal following among operators like the Indian Air Force. However, the production ended in the early 2010s. Restarting production with the exact same configuration might not be the most efficient use of resources. Next, CRPF seeks more VAPS amphibious vehicles. The Central Reserve Police Force is contemplating a larger order for the sophisticated wheeled armed amphibious platform vehicles after witnessing their impressive performance in Kashmir. These advanced 8x8 vehicles, capable of operating both on land and in marshy areas or streams using water jets, were inducted last year and have proven to be a valuable asset in anti-terror operations. Next, a tribute to the pioneers of ISRO's rocket science been paid. In the annals of space exploration, India's journey to the stars is a late of remarkable ambition, ingenuity, and resilience. A recent book sheds light on the lesser known but crucial contributions to India's first rocket projects, offering an enriching perspective on the collective effort that powered the nation's ascent into the space age. Next, US to train Indian astronaut for International Space Station, that is ISS. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson has said that the US Space Agency will expand collaboration with India and it will include a joint effort aboard the International Space Station with an Indian astronaut. Nelson's comments came after a fact sheet issued by the US and the India after the ICET dialogue between US National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan and National Security Advisor Ajit Doval on Monday said they were working toward commencing advanced ट्रेनिंग फॉर इसरो एस्ट्रोनॉट्स इन द US. थैंक यू.